Hello everyone, Shane1288 here with your weekly RuneScape Byte for Monday, November 26th, 2018. This week is a patch week, but we're getting ready for December with all the RuneScape goodies that December brings to everyone for the Christmas holiday season. So starting this year on December 1st, the Festive Aura will be back, and as per usual, that gives a 50% XP boost for 30 minutes, with a maximum of 50,000 XP gained. Winter weekends are also back this year from November 30th to January 7th. Running through the entire span, we have player-owned ports, where you'll get 25 voyages instead of 15, 30% extra resources and trade goods, and the Barmaid Special Voyage will be available on Saturdays and Sundays, as well as the usual Thursday. Now, first up, for the first winter weekend this year, we have Elite Dungeons and Dungeoneering, where you'll be able to get double Dungeoneering tokens from both of them. And in Elite Dungeons in particular, the lore book drop rate will be doubled. You'll get 25% increased Slayer XP from dungeon NPCs, and one extra tier 92 material whenever the materials hit on the drop table. You'll also get one free death per run, and this works in story mode as well as normal runs. Now, in regular Dungeoneering, you'll also get no XP penalty upon death. Moving on to the patch notes this week, we see that Tsunami now casts in the direction of your target rather than whichever direction you're facing. That's a huge usability improvement for that magic ultimate power. It's also no longer possible to restore negative prayer points using the spirit prayer pigs. That's an interesting one. Hidey holes can now be filled while the objects to store are still being worn. That's excellent. Increase the Pakyak summon timer from 58 to 64 minutes to better account for instance length handling. Now for the player on farm, you can now chat to Granny Potterington or access it via a new right-click option to talk to her about which contract buyers should turn up. Timing restrictions still apply in that you'd have to wait until the next day for them to turn up. Doing this will overwrite the standard game mechanic, but that can be turned back on by chatting to Granny at any time as well. It's also worth noting that the small, medium, and large buyers can now individually also be set. Continuing on with the player-owned farm, they have adjusted the values of shiny-boosting traits to sparkling plus 1%, glistening plus 1.5%, and radiant plus 2.5%, which is an increase overall if you stack all three of them on the same animal. And finally, you could now visit another player's Uncharted Island. And with this update, you'll be able to also toggle restrictions on who can visit your island. You talk to Quartermaster Gilly in the island travel options to travel to another player's island, and you can also toggle island settings on island options to allow everyone to visit your island, friends only, or no one. When visiting another player's island, you won't be able to use the skilling resources nor pick up any island customizations. However, you will be able to catch any birds or implings that might exist on that island. You also will not be able to loot treasure chests on claimed islands, and if you log out on a player's island, you'll be teleported back to Waiko. That's it for the Weekly Byte. We'll be back this week to discuss all the patch notes and the upcoming winter weekends on episode 700 of RSBANDB Update. If you found this video at all useful to you or you just enjoyed it, hit that like button and be sure to subscribe to us. You can also join us in-game at FriendsChat BitsBytes. See you this weekend, everyone.